here. I'm Lisa, also known as La Dolce Lisa, and today my name is really going to mean something because I am making a traditional Italian dessert known as zabaione. There are two spellings of it, but either way it is the same dessert. It is basically known as a liquidy custard Italian dessert, sometimes known as a beverage. The definition is very confusing, but it is so easy to make and it is the most delicious dessert. I like this best served over berries or served over cake. You can put this over ice cream. You can literally eat it with a spoon. Think of it almost as an Italian custard because you can even mix it into things like whipped cream or my tiramisu, which I also mix it into as well. But it is basically the best thing you can make. And a lot of Italians whip it up last minute because it is usually with simple ingredients that you have in the house. And it is one of the best last minute desserts. I feel like this is going to be a very light, springy summer dessert, so I figured now is the perfect time to show you how I make my zabaione. Guys, it is so easy and you only need 3 ingredients. So all you need are 3 simple ingredients and a couple of kitchen tools, and you're that much closer to making this delicious, easy Italian dessert. First things first are the egg yolks, because this is considered an eggy dessert. It is basically a 1-to-1 ratio, so if you're using 1 yolk, you'll be using 1 tablespoon of the wine and you'll be using 1 tablespoon of the sugar. Very simple. In this case, I have 3 egg yolks that I already separated. And to that, we are going to be using 3 tablespoons of sugar. You can, of course, use caster sugar, but I'm going to be using this organic cane sugar. I just like it better. Either way, the sugar will melt nicely into the zabaione because we are going to cook it over a water bath. Very simple to do. I will show you how in a second. And of course, we are going to be using a sweet dessert wine. In Italy, they will basically just use any sweet dessert wine of the region, but the most common one to use is Marsala wine. This is my absolute favorite, and this specific brand, the Sferone Cremovo, is my favorite because basically this is the Marsala wine that is already prepared with a bit of sugar and a bit of egg yolks as well. Just smelling this, it's basically what zabaione tastes like. The smell is just exactly how it's going to taste. It is so delicious and I love it. Sweet wine or liqueur that you're comfortable with, but the most classic is this Marsala. So I already pre-measured everything. We're just going to be taking a metal bowl that is going to be going over our water bath in a second, and we're just going to be putting all the ingredients in this metal bowl. 3 egg yolks in the bowl, 3 tablespoons of sugar, and the 3 tablespoons of the Marsala wine right in here. Then we're just going to be giving this a quick whisk. To whisk this right before I put it over the water bath because I feel like incorporating the ingredients first just makes it that much easier to whip up in a second. So we're basically going to be using a water bath or double broiler method. We're just going to be taking any pot here. You're going to be wanting to fill up the pot a third of the way with just water. After we fill this up with water, we are going to be placing this on top and mixing this over a medium to low heat. Once you see the water come to a low boil, it should be bubbling but not a complete full boil, we're going to want to put this right over it, and we're just going to want to keep whisking nonstop until this is zabaione. So basically, use those arm muscles and whisk this up until it turns a very nice pale yellow color. It just depends on how good of a whipper you are. My boyfriend likes to joke and say that I have amazing arm muscles when it comes to whipping up zabaione because I'm really the best at it. You just wanna whip it, whip it, whip it, whip it. All the sugar will be nice and melted and incorporated in this, and it's going to look thick and custardy, and it will be a beautiful pale yellow color. If you find that your water bath is a little bit too high, lower your temperature a little bit, or you can even take this bowl off the heat for a second, give it a whip off, and then put it back on. You can keep doing that if you find that it's cooking fast. It is really important to mix throughout and even scrape the sides of the bowl. You just want to make sure that you're not scrambling the eggs and cooking them right away. You're going to slowly be lightly cooking them so that they're extremely fluffy and frothy and delicious. And that's when you know it's done. So this zabaione is all whipped up. It took about 5 to 8 minutes. I hope that my steps were clear enough. If not, I'm going to write a blog post about this and I will link it down below on ladolcelisa.com so you can find the exact recipe and the written instructions and some little tidbits on there as well. So I transferred the Zabayonet right into here and I'm going to pour it over one of these berries for now. Like I said, you could pour this over cake, ice cream, you can literally eat this with a spoon. You can dip the Savoyardi cookies in it, which is the ones that you use with tiramisu. But I'm just going to pour it over these berries. Look how thick and luscious this Zabayonet looks. It is absolutely beautiful. It is airy and creamy. Let's have a bite because I'm dying to try it. When something's good in Italian like this, that means buono. This Zabayonet is so good. You really taste that sweetness from the Marsala wine with the sugar and the custardy egg yolks. They give this such a velvety and creamy taste. It is the perfect amount of sweetness with these nice tart berries. I just threw this over some blackberries, raspberries, and strawberries, perfect for the summertime. This dessert is delicious. It is so easy to make, as you can see. You just really need a lot of arm muscle to whip the Zabayonet up, and it will honestly be one of your favorite go-to summer desserts. So guys, if you do like these recipe videos, please let me know by giving me a thumbs up and subscribing to my channel. Every subscriber means so much to me. And I will see you in my next video. I'm going to enjoy this Zabayonet off camera right now because I can't wait to eat it. And I know that my boyfriend's dying to try this as well. So I'll just say bye for now and I'll see you in my next video. Bye guys!